Good evening. Good evening, everyone. Good evening. Hi, my name is Scott Neal, and I'm the city manager in Edina. It's my honor and pleasure to be the guy that welcomes you to this event. The city of Edina has been doing this community volunteer recognition event for 38 years. That's a long time. We do it because we think it's important. We think it's important to recognize the contributions that volunteers make to the community. So we do that not only as a city government, but we provide this forum for other community organizations to provide recognition to their accomplished volunteers as well. We've developed a little bit of a protocol and an etiquette to this event over the years, and so I want to tell you a little bit about that before we get started. One is that we conduct the recognition in the order, so mostly in the order that you see in the program tonight. I'll call the presenter up, and whoever is next is on deck, and we'd like those people to kind of be ready to be up and get ready to come up when it's their turn. Second, we ask award winners to be judicious in their acceptance speeches, if you can. And let that Minnesota culture of modesty shine through. Following the community volunteer recognitions, we will have a group of recognitions that are from the mayor. And so Mayor Jim Hovland and two members of our city council, Bob Stewart and Mike Fisher, will come up, and they have some awards that they present on behalf of the city. Just a couple more details. I want to thank a few people that helped put all this together. MJ Lehman. MJ is in the back. Salika Mohammed, who is coming to the door. Salika. The Tin Fish, of course. We always get great service and great food with the Tin Fish. Thank you. And Amy Smith. Amy is back here with the Braemar staff, and Amy does for us. Puts together these kind of events all the time. I do want to warn you, too, that we have two guys that are videotaping this for posterity and archive to our website. Will it be on channel 16 as well? So, you know, we want to keep profanity to a minimum, I think, tonight, right? Okay, great. Well, with that, I will ask our first presenter, Glenn Gray from the Soccer Association, to come and take the podium. And following Glenn will be Lori Severson from the Chamber of Commerce.
Thank you. Hi. I don't know if there's music that comes on when I'm going too long or something like that. Yeah, so I'll try to get through this quickly. My name is Glenn Gray. I'm the current board president of the board of directors for Edina Soccer Association, and it's my pleasure and privilege to introduce Dan Shand. He is the smilest member of the board of directors, and Dan joined the board about 6 years ago. And in his time serving, they brought the numbers up to 4,000. So we have over 4,000 kids in this program, which is pretty amazing. It's not just the largest sports organization in Edina; it's the largest sports organization in Minnesota. So it's pretty impressive. Dan, as well as serving many roles, he's chosen to focus on the pre-K to second grade level. Now, this is, in many volunteer organizations, this is the point where everybody slowly steps back and leaves the rookie volunteer to take that group because it's the largest and the parents are very fierce. So Dan is the opposite. He's embraced this age group and really stepped in to make it a fantastic thing. So if you've any kids or anything that have been in soccer, have probably felt Dan's presence firsthand in some way. He's an advocate for keeping ESA affordable. You know, it's $120 for the season, which is crazy when you think of all the things that they get. He's trying to make sure that it is all inclusive. Everybody, regardless of skill or anything, gets to play. and also keeping it fun, while also keeping learning, teaching these kids to use their core values and skills. So no matter if they take it in for just a recreation thing throughout their life or if they get competitive, they have all started in ESA. So it's pretty cool. He's also coached and brought his calm demeanor to the sidelines and knowledge, and I think he's brought home a trophy or two in the past. And he's served as the board president and vice president. He has spearheaded many of the vital programs that we have going, including our team building automator. That's not the actual name of it. I'm not sure the tool has a name. We just kind of say thanks, Dan, when we use it. It takes 4,000 kids' names, schools, shirt sizes, play with requests, all these things, and turns it into, spits out these well-balanced teams, which used to take individual people with a pen and an Excel spreadsheet over a week to put together. So that's been a fantastic thing. Let's see. You know, and one thing we know about being a volunteer, and everybody here is a wonderful volunteer, you know that any mistakes that are made are never questioned by parents. and they're always brought forth with compassion and patience. So, you know, we've always looked to Dan for his sense of humor and confidence when he's led the board. So, Dan, he's my board member, my friend, father, husband, coach, and consummate man who steps forward instead of back. Please come to the mic.
I don't exactly know how to follow that other than to say, you know, thank you to everybody at ESA, past and present. They've created a really cool organization. It's been great to be a part of it. I'd also like to thank my date tonight, which is my mom, sitting right over there. And so I've got a long speech and a short one. The short one is thank you. The long one is thank you very much.
Now, please help me welcome Lori Severson from the Edina Chamber of Commerce. Lori.
Good evening, everyone. How are you this evening? One of my favorite quotes goes something like this, and it's, if you feel gratitude toward something or someone, but you don't express it, it's like giving a gift but leaving it unwrapped. So on behalf of the Edina Chamber of Commerce, we do want to express our sincere gratitude to Dr. Michelle Norton. She is our 2017 Volunteer of the Year for the Edina Chamber of Commerce. Michelle has given herself and her time in support not only of the business community here in Edina, but of the community overall. She's been a hard and tireless worker with our Ambassadors Committee, our Gala Committee. She's also co-founder of one of our networking groups, the Edina Edge. Every year she steps up to the plate and she does just a little bit more. So again, we'd like to present the 2017 Volunteer of the Year Award to Dr. Michelle Norton.
I wasn't aware I was supposed to say anything, so I'm sorry about that. But I do want to say thank you so much to the Chamber. I started with the Chamber as a brand new business owner, and they've welcomed me with open arms. And so it's really easy to help with an organization that really helps you. And of course, my husband, Brian, he comes along with me to all of my Chamber events and has been a very huge supporter of me and my business and all of that. So thank you very much to both of you. I appreciate it.
Okay, now we will we'll welcome Karen Rorick from Edina Schools and Dick Crockett from the Foundation. You're on deck.
Scott, will you be my Anna?
Oh, sure. Good evening. It's wonderful to be a part
of an event that highlights and celebrates the incredible volunteer efforts happening in our community. Tonight, we would like to recognize Mary Hedges and her support of our Curriculum Resources Program. This program provides an enriching experience by enhancing the curriculum and covers a wide variety of topics, which present endless possibilities for students to learn from volunteer speakers who are experts in their field. Mary Hedges is a research and development technician with General Mills in their yogurt and dairy division. She's been supporting Cornelia Elementary second graders with their chemical engineering unit since 2011. Mary's presentation is catered to build upon the classroom experience the second graders work on throughout their unit. Her slides and samples help the students gain a deeper understanding of the design process, product improvement, and quality control. She demonstrates how General Mills uses surveys for taste tests to gather data on current trends and to plot out consumer demographics for the area. Mary goes above and beyond to volunteer her time in our classrooms by connecting to young learners and enhancing the curriculum with her real-world experience. Her efforts are invaluable, the kids love her visits, and she's definitely helped to light a spark for some future scientists. Please join me in honoring Mary for her hard work and dedication with Edina Public Schools.
Thank you very much. I love working with the kids. They are so cute, and I just love going there. So thank you very much.
She's a yogurt scientist. That is about the coolest job I've heard of in a long time. Mr. Dick Crockett from the Foundation is here, and Jill Atkins from the Women's Club. You are up next.
Good evening, everybody. In 2009, a solo pianist, conductor, and music teacher named Craig Randall Johnson, sitting right over here, came to me with a vision for a community orchestra that would provide an opportunity for skilled musicians to learn new music, great music, and provide occasional public concerts. It was 4 years before he connected with Hillary Santoni, standing beside me, to help bring this vision to reality. And I've had the pleasure of working with her since then, taking advantage of her great experience working with Cleveland United Way, the Toronto Symphony Orchestra, and most recently the Carlson Marketing Group here in Minneapolis. She co-founded Minnehaha Music and has served as its managing director since then. That involves, as all managing directors' jobs do, bringing together lots of moving pieces, in this case 30 to 40 musicians, all their need for rehearsals, the arrangements for public concerts, and building up the development funds to support that effort, and ultimately bring an audience of over 200 people, a multi-generational group, and growing in terms of the audience numbers to help bring this kind of music to Edina. It's a classic example of our work with over 50 different organizations that we have designated funds for, including a few of those here tonight, in serving, strengthening, and building our community. We serve as a charitable giving partner for Minnehaha Music, and this was the right year to pick this particular partner of ours and its manager to receive this award. So here I am very happy to present you as a Volunteer of the Year Award from the Edina Community Foundation.
Thank you very much, Dick. I'm honored to receive this award on behalf of the many people that help make Minnehaha Music successful. And like any orchestra, success depends on collaboration. So thank you, Craig, for supplying the artistic vision for Minnehaha Music. Thank you, Edina Public Schools, for hosting us at the beautiful Southview Auditorium for our concerts and also their rehearsal room. And of course, the Community Foundation, who has provided support and encouragement. The City of Edina and Michael Fry, who also have helped us and continue to provide support and encouragement to us. So appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Now please help me welcome Jill Atkins from the Federated Women's Club, followed by Jenner Stevens from Morningside Women's Club.
You can hold those. They're not yours. So first I'd like to introduce Sue Stover. Sue, if you would raise your hand, she's here to my right. So the Edina Federated Women's Club is a philanthropic and social organization here in Edina. And during our club's history, we have donated over $800,000. Some of you may remember our community service project, the Santa House, that we held right here at Braemar for 24 years. As in any organization, communication is vital to our 92 members, and we have Sue Stover to thank for keeping us all informed of the club's activities. Sue has been our editor of our newsletter for over 20 years. And during that time, she has willingly and efficiently ensured that our members stay connected, not only with each other, but with our community service efforts. We're honored to recognize her tonight, not only for her contributions this past year, but for the last 19 years as well. Thank you, Sue.
Jenner Stevens.
There she is.
Followed by Mr. Tom Gump.
Hi there. My name is Jenner Stevens, and I am the president of the Morningside Women's Club. It is our 80th year as a club. We are a multi-generational group of women, nearly 150 members who are residents and are friends of the Morningside neighborhood. If you aren't familiar with Morningside, we are the little notch in the top of Edina, if you've ever wondered what that is. Morningside was its own city at one point, but now we are a part of Edina. But we still have that small town feel. Our holiday market helped us raise over $13,000 for our scholarship fund, allowing us to award 5 Edina High School seniors with a $2,000 scholarship each. Today, we'd like to recognize our member, Judy Johnson, as our volunteer award recipient. She's lived in Morningside for 53 years. She's been a club member for nearly 45 years, was the president in 1987, and still sits on our board. She always brings a smile and a unique perspective. She has a generous spirit and always shows up to help, even for the jobs that no one else wants to do. She remembers everyone, and it's, in my opinion, she's the unofficial Morningside historian. She knows a little bit about everyone. Please help me welcome or thank her for her all of her hard work and her many years of commitment to our group. Thanks.
I want to thank the club for nominating me. I was very surprised. And for the group that came to represent me tonight. And I love Edina. I love Morningside. I'm trying to decide what to do with my life after my husband died 2.5 years ago. And everybody says, stay in your house, stay in your house. And I'll be 50 years in my house on 43rd in France on September 1st. So.
Again. Congratulations. As you may know, there are 2 Rotary clubs in Edina, and we have the presidents of both of those clubs here tonight. We'll hear first from Tom Gump, president of the Morningside Club, and then Ann Platt. Tom.
Well, you know, in a city like Edina, it's great. We all want to stay in our house for 50 years. So, and the reason we do is because of all the volunteers who are here tonight. And what a great community it is to live in. Since we only have a couple minutes, instead of talking about the list of things that would go on and on, what Rob has done for the Rotary Club of Edina Morningside, I'd like to talk just a brief minute about what kind of person he is, because that transfers into everything else. Of course, Rob has done a lot for Rotary, but he's just a good person. He balances his work. He runs a family business, Sunburst Chemicals in Bloomington, 110 employees, and with his family life. And he's always running off from a meeting to go play volleyball at church and do all these other things that we don't even know about in Rotary. And he's the kind of person that after he was done being president of Rotary, he still stayed involved. So that's the kind of person that I want to live within Edina. So Rob, thank you very much. Thank you.
So how many Rotarians are out in the audience here? Could you all raise your hand? How many spouses of Rotarians do we have here tonight? And I guess what I wanted to share with everyone in the room is how grateful I am to work with such an amazing club and an organization like Rotary that holds service above self and is really dedicated to having fun and making the world a better place and our community a better place. So thank you all. And Tom, thanks for the recognition. I appreciate it.
Right. President Platt.
I've been called a lot of things, but not that. Thank you. I'm Ann Platt. As Scott said, I happen to be the honor of being president of the Edina Rotary Club, and we will be celebrating 60 years as a club in August. Tonight, I'd like to recognize Gary Pedersen, who has been the Rotary Club of Edina's champion for international service projects. He was instrumental in getting a $300,000 water filtration and sanitation project in Guatemala. In addition to securing the money from the Edina Rotary Foundation for the project, he visited other Rotary clubs and received grants from them as well as the Rotary District of 950. He also coordinated the grant writing so this project would receive matching from funds from the Rotary International Foundation. A lot of foundations here. When complete in 2018, this project will have an impact on over 4,000 people who have not had clean, safe water in this area of Guatemala. Gary just returned from Guatemala last week, where he visited the site and saw firsthand the progress that has been made and met some of the community members who will be positively impacted by this project. So it's my honor to recognize Gary Pedersen as our Rotarian of the Year. Thank you, Gary.
An open mic, my gosh. Thank you so much, Ann. I do want to say a couple of things. First of all, I'm honored and it's very humbling to be here with people that give so freely of themselves. And I also think that it's probably a lot of you are just like I feel, and this is that we're following our passion and we're doing the things that are important to us, whether they be local or whether they be international. This is my first major international project, and I will share with you that it is life-changing, and hopefully be life-changing for the people that we benefit. But it's really life-changing for myself and for the Edina Rotary Club and the Rotarians that we can get involved in it. So I want to thank you for honoring me. I do it because it's a passion and I love it, and I hope everyone else does too for the things that they do. Thank you so much.
Now from the Braemar City of Lakes Figure Skating Club, Kathleen Gazich, and we have you listed twice. Does that mean you have two?
Yes.
All right.
So, hi, I'm Kathleen Gazich, and I'm the head professional for the Braemar City of Lakes Figure Skating Club. And I actually nominated two volunteers because they are partners in what they do. Many of you know Bob Coteen. He was the former Park and Recs director for Edina. And Gene Pastor, who was our founding professional for the Figure Skating Club. And so for many years, they have helped our Figure Skating Club in many ways, and one of the best ways that they have given of their time is with our ice show, which requires many volunteers and many hours to put together every year. Bob and Jean design the sets, and Bob goes in that wood shop and he builds sets and decorates our arena with fabulous sets every year. And Jean is one of those volunteers who has helped direct the show for many years, but also she's always there available for any events that we run to help out. And so we just wanted to honor them for all their support of the Figure Skating Club, of Braemar Arena, and all that they do to help us with our ice show. And you can see their fabulous sets April 28th and 9th at the Braemar Arena.
Thank you.
I just want to say this is an honor, but my most important thing to the whole city of Edina, and that I had the opportunity. This man hired me in 1965 and to start Braemar Arena. But my contribution, I hope, has been to the youth and to their sports in this community.
Some 40 years ago, Ken Rosalind, myself, and Fred Richards, we sat around a table and talked about how could we honor our volunteers for a volunteer award thing for the city of Edina. At that time, I was working with probably 1,000 volunteers a year when I was park director. But you know, we didn't really have a place to go. And at that time, we're in the process of building Edinburgh Park. We said, we can have a big group for volunteers out there. We can have 200 to 300 people attend this meeting. Now we've got a location to do this, and Edinburgh Park is where we first have it. That was 38 years ago. I've been to every one of these. I haven't missed one. But it's an honor, really, for you to come up here and honor each one of our volunteers in these organizations. I mean, you can't believe the amount of volunteers that we have in this community and the hours that they do. And I don't think the city could really function without all you people as volunteers. So I want to thank you, and I want to thank the Figure Skating Club for this honor. Thank you very much.
Linda Letkin, you are on deck, but right now I'd like you to help me welcome Jim Nelson from our Human Rights and Relations Commission. Jim.
Good evening. Each year, the Edina Human Rights and Relations honors a member of our community whose good works promote human relations and advance human rights, with an award named after longtime Edina resident and HRRC member Tom Oy. 2 years ago, Samia Mangalik learned about the unique challenges people with visual impairments, especially girls, face. Through her own initiative, she partnered with the Jivan Jyoti Institute for the Disabled in India, learning that in poorer parts of the world, many girls lose their eyesight due to malnutrition. She soon became an advocate for the rights of girls and the visually impaired, organizing fundraisers to assist blind girls in India. She also spent some of her summer working with the blind students of Jivan Jyoti, learning about education for the blind and the work needed to make it more accessible to impoverished communities all over the world. Samia hasn't stopped there. She recently founded and serves as president of Girl Up Edina, a local chapter of the UN Foundation's Girl Up campaign, and is planning fundraisers to contribute to the UN Foundation to promote the health, safety, education, and leadership of girls in developing countries. She's leading several group volunteer days at local women's shelters and actively contacting our legislators to support a bill ensuring education for all refugee girls. All of this is an amazing accomplishment for anyone in our community, but I will make note of this amazing fact, which is that Samia is a high school junior. With confidence that this young woman will continue to make a difference in our world, on behalf of the Edina Human Rights and Relations Commission, I proudly present to Samia Mangalik this year's Tom Oy Award. Samia?
Thank you so much. It is such an honor to be here with such amazing volunteers and community members. I first of all would like to thank the city of Edina. Mm-hmm. I have been so lucky to grow up in a community where diversity and compassion and hard work have always been taught to me in Edina schools. And I would like to thank all the teachers and the staff members who have inspired me and given me so many opportunities. And thank you to my family for dealing with my crazy shenanigans and not really complaining about it. Now more than ever is a time for us to come together and work hard to support people in need. There's a lot happening in the world, but If the last couple months have taught me anything, one person with determination and hard work really can make a difference. And thank you so much.
Linda. Linda Luckin. No? Southdale Y? Anyone? Anyone? Well then, how about Ellen Jones? I saw Ellen here. There she is. Ellen.
I'm Ellen Jones. I'm the president of the Edina Garden Council, and we are proud to introduce you all to our Volunteer of the Year, Diane Bomsta. Diane's been an active member of the Edina Garden Council for decades. The Edina Garden Council is an organization with over 100 members and 5 garden clubs. Diane's been president of her garden club, Hidden Valley, many times, and as well as president of the Edina Garden Council. Diane's been committed with her time and energies to the Garden Council as a volunteer leader for all of our community service projects. In the late winter and early spring, you'll find her involved in seeding. We seed 30,000 seeds for Edina Parks. So she's involved with that and transplanting those garden plants for Edina in our garden greenhouses. In May, you'll find her out planting at a neighborhood garden or at one of the many gardens at Arneson Acres Park. Or you may see Diane at the Edina Garden Council plant sale, held the weekend before Mother's Day. The proceeds of this sale get tilled back into creating beautiful gardens and the removal of buckthorn, among other services to Edina. In July, you'll find Diane helping at the Garden Council's other major fundraiser, our biennial garden tour. In 2016, Diane was chair of the garden sales during our garden tour. Diane's been doing all of this community service quietly and yet consistently for years. I'd like to use a gardening metaphor when I describe Diane. All gardeners understand that the taproot of a plant is the thing that sustains the plant through all sorts of environmental conditions. Its strength enables the plant to overcome droughts and produces nourishment for growth. Diane is our taproot, and we are extremely fortunate to have her. Thank you, Diane, for all that you do.
Well, I want to thank Ellen and the members of the Edina Garden Council. I'm truly humbled by this award. Ellen has told you a little bit about what we do in the Edina Garden Council and our club. But I just want you to imagine, especially if you like to garden or think you might like to garden, a cold day in the dead of winter, planting these little seeds she's talking about, or transplanting these plants that beautify our city parks in the summertime. It's a lot of fun, and if you think you might like it, think about joining us. Thank you.
And now for the balance of tonight's program, I want to yield the podium to the Honorable Mayor of Edina, Jim Hovland. Mayor Hovland.
I still feel kind of emotionally affected by Samia's presentation. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for what you're doing. All of you. I was thinking about the great Lincoln biographer Carl Sandburg, who said, "Time is the currency of life, be careful how you spend it." And I want to thank all of you for using your currency of life and spending it on others. and realizing that there is great reward in that work that you all do, being a philanthropist with your time. So for everyone in this room, I say let's give everyone a hearty round of applause for being the great philanthropist that you are. And one more good round of applause for all those award recipients this evening. Thank you. So the city has some awards that they give out every year, and the mayor's privilege in being able to both sit on a committee that tries to think about who would be rewarding or deserving of such an award, and also we get all kinds of input from people in the community, which is also extraordinarily helpful. And as we start out on these awards, and there are five of them, I'm going to ask Mike Fisher and Bob Stewart from the council to come up here and help me hand these out. I think one will hand the document, and one will hand the award itself. And then if you would sit up here, all of you award recipients, and all of the rest of you as well, we're going to get some photos afterwards. So the first award, and I was looking for former Mayor Denny Metzold, who I thought would be here to accept the award for the Crime Fund. The Mayor's Service Club commendation this year goes to the Edina Crime Prevention Fund. And just as a fallback position, as a safety measure, I talked to Chief Nelson, who sits on that board, and he's going to come up and accept this award on behalf of the Edina Crime Prevention Fund. This is really an incredible organization. All of the donations that they get come in voluntarily. There's no source of federal funds for the monies that they distribute. There's no source of state funds. It's all volunteer contributions from folks like all of you sitting in this room. So they were established in 1970. They provide financial support for a number of Edina community programs in addition to supporting public safety in Edina. The fund is run by volunteers, as many of you know. In 2016 alone, it contributed $135,000 to the city, and over the past 10 years, the fund has donated over $650,000 to the Edina community. Some of the programs currently supported by the Crime Prevention Fund include our canine unit, the Bicycle and Foot Patrol, our medical disposal program, and many of our youth programs, as well as some other wonderful work that they're doing on behalf of the city. So please help me recognize the Edina Crime Prevention Fund for the Mayor's Service Club Commendation Award for 2017.
Well, on behalf of the Crime Fund, I'm pleased to accept this award. The Crime Fund is an outstanding organization that helps us with so many unbudgeted expenses that we come across over the course of each year, and supporting our outreach programs, our motorcycle unit, our canine program. Everything they do helps us kind of build more positive relationships with the community and also deter crime. So thank you very much.
Yeah, just sit down over there. You don't get to tell the chief what to do very often, so just go sit over there, chief. So the next award we're going to give out is the Mayor's Individual Service Commendation, and this is awarded to an individual for outstanding and exceptional volunteer service to the community at large. And I had so many people call me and say, you ought to think seriously about Barbara Lavalure. And it was an alignment of thought on that issue, because she has done so much for our community that we want to recognize. Barbara, do you want to walk up here while we're talking about you? I've got a lot of things to say, so you can make your journey as fast or as slow as you want. Barbara Lavalure is an international photojournalist, spent time living in Europe, was a newspaper reporter, blogger, and as we know, a super volunteer who is passionate and committed to the enhancement of arts and culture in Edina. Barbara first became involved on the Arts Center Board in 2011. In her 6 years as a commissioner, she only missed two meetings. In late 2012, she became the chair of the Public Art Edina Committee. She has also volunteered with Forecast Public Art, an internationally renowned public art enterprise that began in Minneapolis. Through her leadership, Public Art Edina has become a prominently recognized organization throughout the Twin Cities art community. And I'm sure that many of you who have walked the promenade or been over in the Grandview Square area or downtown at 50th and France have started to notice all the beautiful works of sculpture that we have in our town to enhance and beautify our wonderful community. Barbara's skills in fundraising and networking have been an asset to the Edina community through her service. The Arts and Culture Commission and the Edina Arts Center are grateful for her service and leadership, as is the city itself for her many hundreds of hours of service to our community. Barbara, thank you. Thank you so much.
It's very humbling to be recognized in this way by the city that I love so much. I am very proud of what public art has become in our city in the last few years, and I hope that you all take the time and the opportunity to visit the beautiful sculptures that we have at Grandview Square, at 50th and France, and that's soon going to be expanding, and that's so exciting. And of course, the promenade, and that was beautifully expanded last year, and a few months before, you know, it was a whole process. I was very proud to be a part of that, and I'm incredibly proud to receive this mayor award. And I also would like to, well, if you know me, you know that I am out to transform what Edina is known for. Every day, I need art.
You know, when the awards first started being passed out this evening, I was thinking about Dan Shand and the Edina Soccer Association and dealing with these young kids, first and second graders, and it made me harken back to going to a game for one of my grandsons, and the scrum was running all over the field, and then I was looking for him, and there he was in the middle of the field with his t-shirt pulled over his head, kind of walking in circles. And everybody has to find their own sport that wasn't his. Going downhill on a set of skis as fast as you can go and getting kicked off Buck Hill, that's okay for him. But soccer wasn't his deal. So thanks for all that work. I know it's a challenge dealing with those young kids. So, Frank, come on up here. If you all go home tonight, I don't know if you have these documents at home, your abstract, your survey on your house. If you pull it out, or sometime you look at it, there's a good chance this guy's name might be on it, that he surveyed your property at one point in time in his career. And there isn't a nook or cranny in Edina that he doesn't know or care about. In fact, caring is a mild word. He loves every part of Edina. And I want to tell you a little bit about some of the things that he's done. He's been a liaison between the Rotary Club of Edina and the Edina Historical Society for 48 years. Years ago, spurred on by the city's effort to save Cahill School and provide history-themed programs for a building, a group of residents, including Frank, formed the Edina Historical Society in 1969. Their work helped to restore the Cahill School and created a living history field trip program that included the collection of stories and artifacts from Edina's early settlement years. And he continues to look for all kinds of things like that to make sure that we understand and appreciate the wonderful history that started with the village of Edina. The society still works to preserve history from each era of the community's development, from the agricultural era to the present day. For more than 40 years, Frank has been a constant on the Historical Society's board. He's helped to bridge the Edina Historical Society with the Rotary Club, as I mentioned earlier, guiding projects such as the new signage at Tupa Park between the two organizations. I just can't say enough about this gentleman as being just sort of the heart of Edina, and to be able to give him this award is a true delight. Thank you, and help me welcome Frank Hartwell. Thank you.
Thank you, Jim, and thank you all. Edina's been a kind of a history of my family. My great-grandfather moved to Edina in 1874, right after the Civil War. He fought on the North. And that was probably why he came this way. I was kind of appointed. I didn't know it was a lifetime appointment, but but I was appointed to the Historical Society in 1969 when we formed it. It was great, still is great. I have a record myself of my mother being born in Edina in 1897. I was born in Edina in 1932, and I have grandchildren, two of them here, Nick and Jessica, and my wife and other daughter here from Edina, and I think it's great. I think Edina has turned out very well. My father being a surveyor and engineer, we had a lot to do with the division into lots, subdivisions, and all of that that goes on here. I have high respect for the city, and thank you very much for this honor. I don't think I'm going to give up right away. You'll probably have to wait till I die. That's the way it is. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. And your Lucite lights there?
Yeah. One more thing for you, Frank, as soon as you get seated.
But I'll bring them.
Every year when we talk about commendations for youth, we have this discussion about, well, we usually have just one recipient in each category, but for young people, I think it's really important that we recognize them and encourage all of this beautiful work that they're doing in already caring about community and caring about humanity. So I'm going to ask these four to come up and just stand up here while I talk about each one of them. Madison Banks, Josh Everts, Nico Iskos, and Om Jahagadir, Girdar. Excuse me. Om. I'm going to talk about Om first, but we had a cute little conversation at our table where Om and his family is sitting along with his brother Atman, who is on the debate team at Edina High School. And Atman, do you want to tell everybody what grade you're in?
I'm seventh grade.
He's on the high school debate team and he's in the seventh grade. But he got that motivation from his brother Om, who I'm going to talk about now. As a sophomore, which he is right now, Om sought out resources at Edina High School to figure out how to start a nonprofit organization. On a trip to India, our Om helped to give eye exams to children who normally can't afford basic eye care. Om became inspired to help more school children. Now the organization that he founded provides eyewear and eye care to children in India. So his dad tells me that to date, they have provided eyewear and eye exams for over 70 kids in India. And this is as a sophomore in high school. Om. Congratulations. Why don't you come up right now? I think I'll let each one of them speak as we talk about each one of them.
I'd like to thank the mayor and the committee for choosing me for such an honor, as well as my parents and my brother and my grandma, who's visiting from India. And this is her last day, actually. And also two of my mentors, Pankaj and Kalpana Gupta. I have been legally blind, so without my glasses, since I was in elementary school. So the issue of visual impairment is very close to my heart. And so when I went to India and saw these children who could not afford even simple eye care, it was very troubling to me. And according to the World Health Organization, over 90% of visually impaired people are impoverished people who cannot afford care. So it's great, and I'm privileged and blessed to live in the city of Edina, where people care and are generous enough to help with such an issue. Thank you.
Om Jahagirdar, thank you. Edina High School seniors Josh Everts and Nico Iskos. You guys want to walk up here? Thank you. They were among the first students to submit their applications for what's called the community service letter. I think we all know from going through school that there have been historically letters for athletes. They have a program, a wonderful program at Edina High School to recognize other kinds of service to the school district. And one is the community service letter at Edina High School. And so even though there were many applicants for this letter, their work stood out. These two played cello and piano duets for senior residents at English Rose Suites Interlochen Home and patients at Park Nicollet Methodist Hospital. The volunteer coordinator at Park Nicollet wrote, "They have gone above and beyond to ensure our patients are able to provide them feedback or request specific music during their volunteer shifts here. I am so impressed by their maturity and reliability. Please help me congratulate these two young gentlemen on the fine work that they've done." Josh and Nico.
Excellent. Well, firstly, I would like to thank the City of Edina, as well as Mayor Hovland, and English Rose Suites and Park Nicollet, which were some of the organizations that we worked with. And although I haven't prepared a speech, I thought it might be useful to share a little story from when we first started volunteering at English Rose Suites, actually. And I remember one of the first times I went to the English Rose Suites home with my cello. The first piece I played was one of the Bach cello suites, which is one of my favorite pieces of music. And I thought, oh, well, they'll love it, and it'll be a huge hit. And so when I first started playing, I was just kind of starting the first suite, and I hear a resident called Jack say, he says, "Where is all that racket coming from?" And so at this point, I kind of realized there was a problem, and another resident was actually covering her ears in discomfort. So I thought, well, Bach probably isn't going to work out so well. So after that, we actually learned to adapt our repertoire, and we learned a little bit about the residents of these homes, and we integrated some of the music that they would have recognized from their time, from 50s and 60s, music like As Time Goes By or Rock Around the Clock for piano and cello. And so that was interesting to learn. But importantly, I think that volunteering, it allowed me to develop my skill to adapt. And I think that skill will not only help me later in life, but I think it also helped me to maximize my effect on the community. And for that, I'm very thankful.
I would echo many of the same things that my partner Nico said. I think that this volunteering experience has been both enriching for the people we play for, and especially for us, because both of us have played music for a long time, and most of the time it's hard to see exactly how playing music can impact the community around us. And I think this volunteering experience has allowed us to see exactly how necessary music is in people's lives. And people listen to music every day, and there are people who don't have that opportunity. And so it's been very interesting to see how we can bring music into people's lives and how that impacts them. And I think it's shown that music is extremely necessary, and just like anything, you need it to live a quality life.
Josh and Nico, if you'd sit down over there. And Madison, you want to walk up here with me? So this is Madison Banks. She is, as they say at the Southdale Y, the definition of thriving youth. Whenever the YMCA staff needs a youth perspective, they call on Maddie. Madison has been involved with nearly every youth program that the YMCA offers: government, Model United Nations, Model Assembly, and Camp Kikiyapi Leadership Club. She has volunteered with the Y's young athletes and tumbling programs and assisted with fundraisers, including tree lot sales and phone-a-thons. The Southdale YMCA is fortunate to have such a giving and positive young adult involved in so many of its programs. Please help me congratulate Madison Banks on the great work she's doing.
I did not know I needed to prepare a speech. I'd like to say thank you to my grandmother, who's standing right there taking my picture. I've been volunteering with the Y for the last 6 or 7 years, and it's always been a great experience. I've learned so much from helping with little kids, and it's always just such a great thing to do. And I'd also like to thank Nicole, who's there on her phone too. Sorry, I have to call people out. It's one of my hobbies. She's been one of the camp leaders for the last year, and it's been great watching her grow. I know, that's usually vice versa. And it's just been a great experience because I started going to camp when I was 4 years old at Camp Kichiyapi. And I've been volunteering there for the last 5 years. And it's just been a second home to me. And everyone there is just so great. And I'd also like to thank the mayor and everyone else here for volunteering too. That's it.
Well, with the, I don't want to call them kids, but we do have a kids emphasis here today with mayors connecting with kids commendation being the next commendation coming up. This is awarded to an individual organization making a positive impact on the lives of Edina youth. And this year that organization is Camp Enterprise. I think, Kip, are you going to come up and, Sam's coming up too? Yeah, come on up, you guys. I see Peter Kelly from our club is not here, but, all right. All right. Camp Enterprise, sponsored by the Rotary Clubs of Edina and Edina Morningside, provides high school students with a unique opportunity to learn about leadership, business, and the free enterprise system. Camp Enterprise of Minnesota was established by the Rotary Club of Alexandria and taken over by the Rotary Club of Edina in 1980. When the Edina Morningside Rotary Club was chartered in 1990, they became equal partners with this local project. There are approximately 25 such programs nationwide. During the three-day autumn camp, presentations are made by business executives and entrepreneurs who share their experiences with students and answer questions about a variety of fields and interests. Students also participate in a series of customized team-building experiences. The students break into teams and focus on a business-based study, which culminates in team presentations. At the conclusion of camp, several students are awarded scholarships each year based upon participation and leadership during the camp. Each student who attends the camp is sponsored by the Rotary Club, meaning there is no cost to students or their families to attend. More than 100 students from Minnesota and Western Wisconsin participate in Camp Enterprise, representing more than 50 high schools every year. The Rotary Clubs of Edina and Edina Morningside spend most of the year planning the camp and rely on dozens of volunteers. Leadership rotates between the clubs, and here to accept the mayor's commendation are Kip Peterson and Sam Thompson from the Noon Club, the Edina Club. Thank you, Kip.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, man, you said it all, that was great. Really what it is, it's a business camp for high school juniors and seniors. And if you've seen the show, the TV show Shark Tank, there are some similarities where the students have to put together a business and then at the end of the camp present to venture capitalists or sharks. So it really is life-changing for many of these students. I've seen it, I've heard it, and I've been honored to be part of it, and I thank you for this award.
So as you might imagine, as one of the largest service projects between the two Rotary Clubs in Edina, it really does take an army of volunteers to make Camp Enterprise work. Every year we have over 80 Rotarians and other volunteers participate in Camp Enterprise. We have a number of people in the room here tonight who have supported Camp Enterprise. The presidents of the two Rotary Clubs from Edina, Ann Platt of Edina Noon, Tom Gump from Edina Morningside. One of our prior recipients, Rob Laughlin, is a past chair and a regular counselor at Camp Enterprise. Sam and I really are humbled to receive this award on behalf of Camp Enterprise and all of its volunteers over the year. We very much appreciate Mr. Mayor Hovland's recognition of us, and thank you.
So every year we try to recognize a city employee that's done outstanding work in their field and also for the community, for the mayor's community involvement commendation. And this year we're recognizing Deb Mangan. And I'm sure many of you in the room know her as our city clerk. If you remember the former Secretary of State, Mark Ritchie, who is now working on bringing a World's Fair to Minnesota, told me one time, he said, "You've got the finest city clerk in Minnesota. Talk about running a clean election. You'll find none better than one run by Deb Mangan." So where is Deb? Can you walk up here? She's going to take her time coming up because she had some surgery here recently. And this neck brace isn't caused from her working with Scott Neal. There was an actual surgery involved. So I'm going to talk about Deb a little bit. She has a dual degree in special education and elementary education. She taught in Minnesota and Wisconsin in the early mid-70s before she began working for municipal government in 1978. Deb's worked for the city of Edina since July 1995 and worked for the city of Chaska before her time in Edina. Deb attended the Minnesota Clerk Institute and was certified in 1993. She was certified with the International Institute of Municipal Clerks in 1998. She's been a member of the Minnesota Clerks and Finance Officers Association since 1980 and served as the MCFOA board president in 2013 and 2014. And they came over to the city of Edina to the city council one evening and gave her a special award for that great work that she did. She serves on the Records and Retention Task Force 1993 to present. She was the city of Edina representative on finding common ground on election reform that took place at the Humphrey Institute in 2009 and 2010. She's been directing elections both in Edina and Chaska since 1978. She has trained countless election judges through the use of paper ballots, punch cards, and optical scan election equipment. Her leadership has been critical in ensuring fair and free elections in our community, and we could not thank her more for being the wonderful person that she is and the tremendous leader in her vocation. Thank you, Deb.
So if any of you want to be an election judge, I can hook you up. I'm very humbled by receiving this award on behalf of the team of Edina employees. I appreciate the mayor and council's leadership, and I thank you.
We're going to take some photos in a moment, so all of you be patient here with us while we wrap up. And I was thinking about the young people that are here with us this evening, and you heard how articulate they are, how proud we should all be of all of them, plus our other volunteers that are all at different stages of life. And it caused me to think about something that I read recently. I'm not going to get it quite right, and I'm not going to get the attribution right, but it's something to the effect that what we have done for ourselves dies with us, but what we have done for others lives on and becomes, in some circumstances, immortal. So particularly for you young people who have already figured this out, that life to have meaning has to mean service to others, we thank you for being so mature, for your age, and for all of the rest of you in this room, we thank you for your spirit of volunteerism and your recognition that we're all in this together and that life and humanity are so important to all of us. Thank you.